Hi everyone, I'm Nikki, co-founder at jexo, and today we will learn more about value versus effort prioritization technique. Value versus effort model is the simplest and quickest of all prioritization techniques. It's best fit for prioritizing new products or MVPs, personal to-dos, or small backlogs, but also for prioritizing product feedback. Given its simplicity, you can prioritize with it literally anything. This prioritization method is pretty simple. You need to assess two key metrics for your priorities, value and effort. Once you fill these, you can calculate the priority score and use priority matrix to identify quick wins. To assign value metric, ask yourself question, how does this contribute to our goal? And assign values from low to high. To fill effort metric, ask how difficult it is to deliver the task. You can use t-shirt sizes for estimation. Teams are usually much more comfortable with them because they don't need to commit to any specific time frame. Once you assign these metrics, you can calculate the priority score with the following formula. However, this method is much more popular to be used together with value versus effort priority matrix. You can simply create a chart where on x-axis you place value and on y effort. When you split chart in the middle, it creates quadrants. You can then identify a low effort and high value quadrant where you can often find quick wins, or in other words, low hanging fruit. Another useful quadrant is high effort and low impact. Priorities in this quadrant can be referred to as time and money sinks. Other two quadrants represent big projects, the one with high value and high effort, and fill-ins, the low value and low effort ones. As you can see, when using priority matrix, it's very easy to identify what's best to start working on first and create a plan. Now let's have a look at real example. I have an example backlog with tasks to prioritize in Jira, and I'm using Foxly prioritization app for Jira to record our metrics. First, we will be assigning value and answering question, how does this contribute to our goal? The goal in this case is to decrease churn. Keeping this in mind, the onboarding video brings high value because currently we are lacking with our user onboarding and not enough users get to aha moment fast enough. For the navigation redesign, value isn't as high. When we ran user testing, there was a little confusion about the meaning of the icons in the navigation, but no other high severity usability issues were discovered. Adding new filters is medium value. We received feedback from potential customers that they can't continue using the tool because they can't get the view they need. Alright, so now we are done with assigning value and it's time to assess effort. Onboarding video is going to be quick. Almost no coding is required here and it will be done fast, so it's XS. Navigation redesign is L. In this task, we need to get design involved, we need to carefully test designs, build new navigation, and also rewrite documentation. Adding new filters is medium. Now when we assigned all metrics, we can order our backlog by tasks with highest priority and see what tasks is more important to start with. You can also use priority matrix to identify quick wins, tasks with highest value and lowest effort, and time sinks, tasks with lowest value and highest effort. If you are looking for a backlog prioritization tool that integrates with Jira, where you can use this template, you can try our app, Foxly. It's really fun and easy to use and helps keep everyone in your team and stakeholders up to date with the latest priorities. If you feel that value versus effort prioritization technique might not be the right one for you and your team, have a look on our other videos where we introduce other prioritization techniques like RISE, ICE, weighted shortest job first, or quick wins method. See you in the next video and in the meantime, happy prioritizing!